Today we will discuss about binary coded decimal. Till now we have discussed about different number systems and conversions of number systems, how to perform binary addition and how to perform binary subtraction using complements. Now we are discussing about binary coded decimal. What is this actually? Why we need to study this? Is that, see here, binary coded decimal, so because of a digital clock is used to store the decimal digits, where each digit is separately represented as its binary equivalent. So see here, if you want to represent 3, what we have to do is we have to make it this light to on. So in order to make that on, we have to use on and off. Like 1 indicates it's on, 0 indicates it is off. So here we have 0 0, and the remaining cases we have 1 1. So why we have to study this, especially for some applications, binary will not be preferred. Binary coded decimal will be preferred. So in this case, we will use a binary coded decimal. So in this, let me go. So this is BCD. So in this BCD, okay. So what is this BCD? Whatever the decimal number is there, we are representing in binary in a coded way. Okay, so this is also referred as the code as 8421. Okay, so if it in the question paper asked as perform 8421 addition and subtraction, it is nothing but BCD. So why we will go for a DCD, a BCD for some applications like digital clock internally, it uses decimal, but in order to represent that, we are using internally binary. So for that, definitely we have to know about what is this BCD and all. Now before going for what is this BCD, first question is what the decimal number, whatever it binary coded decimal, the decimal number you are coding in binary. So definitely you have to know how many symbols present in decimal so that you can code in a binary. Now tell me, what is the R in decimal? Decimal base equals to what, ma? In order to code this decimal to binary, first you must know how many symbols, what is the base of this decimal, then you can code in a binary, right? So tell me, a decimal base is what? Yes.
10.
10.
Okay, 10. It is 10, right? So, but the symbols used are, the range will be from 0 to, in the first class I discussed, the range will be from 0 to R minus 1. So the largest number will be 10 or 9?
9.
9. Okay. 0, 1 until it is 9. So for this numbers, you have to represent in binary. This decimal you have to represent in binary. For that, what we are doing is, in order to let me go for the largest one called 9. For this representation, how many bits we required in order to represent 9 in 8421? Let us consider this is 8421 code. So 8421 means I have to place in place of 81 and in place of 11, so that 8 plus 1 we will get 9, and the remaining places we can place as 0. Now is this which number? It is 9, right? So how many bits we need in a binary in order to represent this decimal? We need to require how many bits? E number lo any bits unnayamma? 4 bits. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 bits are required in order to represent this decimal symbols to a binary. Now is the first question. If it is 4, then I am using 2 power 4 equals to how many combinations you can get? 16 combinations you can get, right? So let me show this example. So here, just now I explained about binary coded decimal, the decimal number we are representing in a binary. For that, you must know the binary, how many digits are there. Here, each digit 0 to 9, the representation is from 0 to 9. So for that, we have to use 4 bits. So the we are using 4 bit BCD code for every particular single digit in decimal. So here 0 is represented. If you see 8421, so if you are not getting, you just write 8421 like this and try to write if you are representing 0. So 0 means you have to place all zeros. And if you are representing 1, in place of 1, you have to place 1, and in the remaining places, you have to place 0. So in this way, you will get all the numbers from 0, for 1, for 2, and so on until 9. Now is the first question. If you want to represent in 10, listen all of you, this is very important. And if you want to, everyone knows that is the digits are from 0 to 9 only. Now let us consider, I want to represent 10. So we are using 4 bit for representing the BCD. So 10 also I can represent as what? 1 0 1 0. Why? Because it is 8 4 2 1. So 8 plus 2, you will get 10. So in place of 8 I placed 1, in place of 2 I placed 1. But this is invalid. Why? Because we should convert only the decimal digits to binary code. So this is invalid. Why it is invalid? In a given number, we have 2 digits. Is it? Yes. So why? Because I have already given that the decimal symbols you have to write from 0 to 9. In this, if you want to represent 10, 10 is not a valid number. So it is in this 10 we have 2 digits in a given number. So individually you have to represent 0 as previously based on this table. This is a table. In order to represent your 0, here we have 0000, and for 1 we have 0001. In that case, in this 10, how to represent ma? Can anyone? How to represent this 10 in BCD, not in binary? So this one.
0001
0001 and 0 is 0000. In this way you have to represent. Okay, in this way you have to represent. Whereas in binary is different case. Now let me explain the differences between a binary and a BCD so that you will get which one is efficient. Let me take which one is efficient. First is binary versus your BCD. Okay, now the same example, I don't want to take one more example. Let us take the same example. In 10 we will represent in binary as 1010. Okay, so how many bits it is occupying in order to store this inside a memory? It is occupying only 4 bits, right? Now let us consider, if I want to store this inside my memory in a BCD format, then definitely how many bits it is occupying? 8 bits. Okay, so now tell me, what is it? Can anyone tell me which one is efficient? Let us consider the n number of ways we can consider the differences. First is in place of a memory. When you consider a memory, then definitely the space occupied in order to store the numbers in a BCD, it takes a much memory in order to store. And even if you want to perform an addition, what happens, ma? You have to take equal number of bits while performing addition. If A is 8 bits, then definitely you are taking B also as an 8 bit and performing addition. So in this case also, it takes some time. But the advantage of this is, can anyone? The advantage of this is, it is easy. It is very much easy to convert from decimal to BCD format, right? So whereas in, let me explain why it is easy so that you can understand. Take an example, decimal number 137. So if I take an example, decimal number 137, let us take 137. So I want to first represent this in a binary. Can anyone tell me the answer for this? I want to represent decimal number 137 in binary. Start doing in your notes and tell me the result. Don't share in the chat box. Unmute and tell me the answer. ఏం చేయాలి? మల్టిప్లికేషన్ చేయాలా? డివిజన్ చేయాలా? డెసిమల్ టు బైనరీ.
వన్ జీరో 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 వన్ జీరో జీరో వన్
వన్ జీరో జీరో జీరో
వన్ డబల్ జీరో
వన్ డబల్ జీరో వన్
మ్యామ్ after that
correct one, ma'am adhe correct ma'am 100 1001
okay 1000 1001 is it an answer
yes ma'am
okay okay everyone got the same answer no why because I don't have a solution so now going for 137 in BCD so here how can I write one in this as 0001 coming for 3 I can write as 0011 coming to 7 we have to write as 0111 so if any bits unnayamma total ga BCD count chesi cheppandi ok sari 444 how many bits totally it is occupying 12 coming for the above one it is occupying any bits occupy chestundi idi
8
okay na but converting from one decimal to BCD is it easy or converting decimal to binary is it easy so converting decimal to binary means given number is larger than converting that is that it takes some time whereas in BCD it is easy so it BCD also have a disadvantages and advantage also the advantage is that it is very easy to convert from decimal to binary and definitely for some applications definitely you have to go for a BCD like digital clock like converting finding out the frequencies all those definitely you have to go for a BCD so this is a difference between binary and BCD binary it occupies less space but coming to a BCD it takes much memory space but the advantage is that it is easy to convert and it is easy to implement a circuit hardware circuit whereas here as it involves a conversion mechanism it is somewhat complicated so let me show the slide so that you can even more clearly you can understand so until here it is clear right everyone so until 9 so let me take the other example for example BCD number given as 1895 so convert to BCD is simply representing each digit in 4 bits like 0001 8 as 1000 9 as 1001 and 5 as 0101 based on the code called 8421 8421 is also called as a BCD code so now see here this you have to mention in your notes why because this table will be used in the third unit for calculating K maps so until 9 it is representation whereas from 10 to 15 we need to consider as don't care we need to consider as don't care so why because these are weighted codes listen ma these are weighted codes if you write 10 in 0001 and 0000 what happens it is representing 8 bits so it's not valid so consider this as don't care now coming to why BCD just now we discussed it is easy to encode and decode decimals into BCD and vice versa and it is simple to implement a hardware algorithm and it is very much easy and it is useful and it is the applications where we will use the BCD is digital voltmeters frequency converters digital clocks all we will use a BCD now coming for the advantage so BCD is not same as binary everyone must keep in your mind that BCD is not same as binary what maximum of the students will do given a binary number convert means just now you have said that 1001 1001 but they will convert to BCD as it is simple so don't do like that BCD is completely different from binary and the limitations of BCD is that for each and every digit it uses 4 bits so memory space occupies will be more coming to BCD addition note down in your notes BCD addition is very 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 important so definitely one question will be asked so BCD addition so how we will perform BCD addition let us consider 4 plus 5 4 need to be converted in BCD so that we'll get 0100 5 need to be converted to BCD so that we'll get 0101 so if you add we'll get 9 so 9 is a valid BCD number so it is correct coming to 4 plus 8 4 and 8 both are valid BCD but after calculating you are getting invalid BCD it should be valid when I will say valid BCD when I will say invalid BCD is that when the result that I got is equal to 9 or less than 9 then the result that I got is a valid BCD here we got 12 12 is not a valid BCD so what to do in order to make this to correct is a first question so see here adding 6. If sum becomes greater than 9, so we need to add 6. Why to add 6 is the first question. So see here, just now I said that. So there are 4 combinations. So if there are 4 combinations, means 2 power, how many combinations we will get, ma? Any combinations of say 2 power 4 and day? 16 combination. Andilo manam enni use chestunnamo? 0 to 9. 0 to 9 use chestunnam. 10 represent chestunnama? No. 10 to 15 we are not representing. We are not representing. 0 to 9 we are using. Means here 10 0 to 9 means we will get 10. So see here, used combinations 0 to 9, 10 combinations, and unused combinations 10 to 16, which is nothing but 6. So whenever we are getting an invalid BCD number, then we have to add that to 6 so that we'll get the actual result. This is very important. In a small 1 mark answer, you will get why there is a need of adding 6 is that. So as we are having 16 combinations, in that 16 combinations, we are only using until 9. And 10 to 15, these 6 combinations are don't care. So in order to make the answer correct, we have to add 6 to that. Okay. Now let me take an example. The previous example, okay, the other example. So this is your example, 8 plus 9. Okay. Let me take an 8 plus 9. ఏముంది అమ్మ అక్కడ 8 ప్లస్ 9 ఏనా ఓకే 8 ప్లస్ 9 ఓకే సో 8 ఇస్ రిప్రజెంటెడ్ ఇన్ బీసీడీ యాజ్ 1 0 0 0 9 యాజ్ 1 0 0 1 ఓకే సో నెక్స్ట్ we have to perform simple binary addition. So everyone knows binary addition how to do, right? So 1 0 0 0 1 ఓకే See here, just now I said that if it is greater than 9, we have to add 6, right? So what the answer we got is incorrect, right? 8 plus 9, enta raval manaki? What answer we have to get, ma? 8 plus
9?
17. 17. Do we got the answer 17? No, right? So why? Because there are 2 cases you have to follow while doing BCD addition. First case is, if there is a carry from MSB to the, whenever we are considering as 4 bits, we will consider 4 bits as a nibble. Okay, this is very important. Ma. So, we are representing BCD in 4 bits. So, 4 bits we will consider as a nibble. Okay, so whenever there is a carry from a nibble, means 4 bits aipen tarvata, whenever there will be a carry, then definitely what you have to do is, even if it is less than 9, even the result generated is less than 9, you have to add 6 to that. Okay, you have to add 6 to that. This is the first rule. So what you will get? 1110. And this one you have to write as it is. And in order to make this as a valid 4 bits, you have to make add up. So finally, you will get 1 and 7. So you got the result as 17. So let me give a rule so that you can understand. So what we have done here, A represented in binary as 1000, 9 as 1001. So if you add, there is a carry generated after a nibble. Okay, nibble means 4 bits. Why I am representing as a nibble means, here I have considered only 8 plus 9. But in your exam, you will not get like simple 8 plus 9. You will be getting as 2, 3, 4 plus 6, 2, 3, like this. So this 4 will be considering as one nibble. We are internally, if you convert to BCD, you will be represented as 0, 1, 0. So when there is a carry from nibble to nibble, from lower nibble, we will be considered this side as lower nibble, this side as higher nibble. Whenever there is a carry from lower nibble to higher nibble and the result generated is less than 9, then you have to add 6. This is the first case. Okay, first you must know what is a nibble. When carry is generated, what you will do. So this is your nibble, where 4-bit representation. From that, if you are getting a carry and the result is less than 9 also, you have to add 6 to that. Let me show an example. So see here, see the rules, ma. BCD addition rules. If you know the rules, then you within a second you can complete your addition very easily, ma. So rules are very important. What you have to do. So BCD addition rules. So if the result is greater than 9, for further you have to do for all steps adding 6. What is this for all these steps? I will explain. So next is what, when a carry occurs in the first addition step only, first addition step lo matrame we will see this carry from one digit to another. Means from one digit ante, one digit is nothing but one, this, if you see this in a decimal it is a digit, but if you see this in a binary it will be a nibble. So from one nibble to another nibble, if there is a carry, again we have to add a 1 to this. Okay, if a carry occurs in the first addition step only, from one digit to another, means 4-bit. So then also you have to add a 6 to that. So this is in this way also we can explain the rules of BCD addition. See here, if the result generated is less than or equal to 9, and if no carry generated, the answer is correct. Mere em cheyalsina avasaram ledhu, correct answer calculate chesindi correct untundi. Now let us consider, if sum is less than or equal to 9, carry generate ayindi in mana previous case laga. So em ayindi ikkada manaku less than e undi, but what happened, there is a carry generated from this nibble. So appude em chesam manamu, we added a 6. So in this is a case that we discussed just now. So it is less than, sum is less than or equal to 9 and carry generated. So in that case, add 6 to the sum to get the correct answer. Now let us see the other case. The sum generate ayindi manaku 9 kana ekku undi anukunnamu, carry generate em avvaledu. So what happens, again we need to add 6 to that. The only case where you should not add 6 is that the carry the result generated is less than or equal to 9 and carry generate avvaledu. In that case we should not do anything. The answer generated is correct. Note down my steps is very important. Idi ardhamainda andarki? So this you can understand even more clearly if you take an example. So this is an example, try to see. Can anyone tell me what is this NC? Indake cheppanu, this is a 4-bit whenever there is a carry generated. So in this case NC is nothing but there is no carry generated. Okay, so let me explain the first case. 52 plus 46. Okay, 52 plus 46, 5 in BCD representation we are representing as 0101, 2 as 0010. Coming for 4, we are representing as 0100, 6 as 0110. Okay. Now, if you add, what happens? 0 plus 00, 01 plus 101, 01. And is there any carry generated from this lower nibble to higher nibble? Anyone? Generate in amma lower nibble to higher nibble carry?
No,
there is no carry generated. Okay. Next, in this case, you will get 1001. So ippudu manaku ochina answer it is 8, this one is 9. So even if it is less than also, you have to see is there any carry generated from lower nibble to higher nibble. Adi kuda ledu kabatti we should not do anything. The answer generated is correct. Okay, is it clear the first step, why we are not adding any 6 to this? Why? Because from lower nibble to higher nibble, there is no carry generated. Ippudu mana carry generate ayindi ante, even if it is less than, you have to add 6. But mana carry generate avaledu kabatti the answer generated is correct. Now let us see the other example. 17 plus 56. Let me go. Meanwhile, others, if you are perfect, can do. Em undi amma ka number 17 plus
56.
Em ravali answer, what should be the answer? Okay, let me start. I have written 1 as 0001 and 7 as 0111, 5 as 5 representation, 6 as 6. Now let me add 1 0 1 1 1 1. Next is 0 1 1 1 0. Now is there any carry generated here? No, it is 0. Let me write as 0. Now, but what is this number 1101 is equivalent to which number? 13 or 14? 13. 13 ante mana correct result?
No,
we have to, it is invalid. We have to add 6. Coming to this one, is it correct? Yes, 6 is correct only, right? And there is no generated carry also. So in this case, I have to write simply as 0000. Now perform addition. So yes, ma, let's try to concentrate here. Then first time annanu step lo is whenever you are having in this step. So we have to do only for the first addition step only. Carry occurs in the first addition step only. We have to check. Ante enti ante. See here, first time meeru first consider cheskuna appudu addition, whenever you are doing an addition, if there is a carry, in that case you have to do. But once a result generated, and once if you are adding 6 to this, okasari malli ikkada emaina carry ochinappudu you should ignore. Only for the first case you have to check the carry. Okay na, let us see ikkada manaki emaina ostunda chuddam. So 1 1 0 1. Yes, osund kada, you are getting 1 1 1 plus 1 0 1, and again 0 1. Yes, there is a carry generated 1. Let me write here. Next is 1 1 1 0. So this is a case, right? So in this case manaku vachindi entamma result 7 inka
3.
But according to the steps and what I mentioned, if there is a carry from lower nibble to higher nibble, then what I mentioned, you even if it is less than 9, you have to add 6. But don't do that mistake. So what you have to do, only for the first time you have to do that. For the next time onwards, when there is greater than 9, when you are adding 6 and when there is a carry generated, you have to ignore this. Okay, maximum of the students will do this mistake. Is the answer generated is correct?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So next time malli manam chese time lo, whenever there is a carry generated, you should ignore that. Even if next time you should not check. Okay. Now let me go for the other example. Why I am taking this these many examples for BCD is that the number of whenever you are taking the different numbers, the combinations of getting the result will be different. Ma. So I am explaining all the combinations so that you should not face any problem while doing BCD. Addition. So this is one more example. See here. So there is a 39 plus 28. So 3 we are representing as 0011 and 9 as we are representing as 1001, 2 and 8. So when there is a, when you are adding here, we are getting 1. It is valid, but what is happening? There is a carry generated from lower nibble to higher nibble. Enduku ante ikkada we are having 1 and 1, 0. We are placing 1 here. So that is the reason, even if it is less than 9, we are adding 6 here. Whereas in this case, there is no carry generated. So finally, this is your answer. Do it in your notes, ma, so that you can understand why we are, for 1 also, why we are adding 6. Is it clear? Why we are adding 6 here? Yes, ma. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Understood why we are adding 6 here? Can anyone?
Carry is generated.
Yes, yes. Carry is generated because of that we are adding 6. So let me take the other example. The other example is 71 plus 65. So here there is no carry generated. So because of that, we are not adding any 6 to this, simply 0. But here, why we are adding 6 to this is, it is greater than 9. So this number is 13. So because of that, we are adding 6 to this. Okay. So when carry from one nibble to another nibble, only for the first time you have to follow. Whereas greater than 9, you have to follow for each and every step. For this until you get... until you get less than 9, you have to go on, you have to do the addition. Okay. Next, let me take the other example. 87 plus 15. 8 is represented as 1000, 7 is represented and we are doing addition. So whenever we are doing addition, what happened here? It is 9. Okay, no problem. We should not add anything. Whereas here it is, what is this number? 1100, it is?
12.
So 12 greater than 9 kabatti, we are adding 6. Again, after adding, what happened? Because there is a carry generated from here, from this lower nibble to higher nibble, because of that, it is converted from 9 to 10. So again, what happened? You should not stop here. Until and unless the final result should be equal to 9 or less than 9, ala chestune undal. So here, 1010, here 0010. But here what happened? There is a carry generated, but we have not added 6 here. In this case, okay, children, 1 plus 1 0 1 1 plus 1 0 1, there is a carry generated. Okay, so even there is a carry generated, as this is not the first step we are doing, we need to ignore it, and we are adding only 6 zeros, and for this 10, as it is greater than, we are adding 6. So this is your result. Now let me give one question. 2 3 4 plus 2 1 2. Chest cheppandi amma naaku result. 2 3 4 plus 2 1 2. Tell me in binary representation, BCD representation. Yes, got an answer.
0 1 0 0 0 1 0.
Okay, and others, ma, is everyone able to do BCD addition? It is very important. If cheyagalutunnara, emaina problem face avutunda? Just rules follow avandamma, it's enough. What only two rules? If it is greater than 9, we have to add 6. And for the first time, whenever you are doing, if there is a carry generated from lower nibble to higher nibble, even if it is less than 9 also, we need to add 6. These are the two steps we need to follow for doing BCD addition. Why? Because next concept is BCD subtraction. Again, we have to do that BCD subtraction using BCD addition only. Like in a binary addition, for performing binary subtraction, what we have done, ma? We have done a negative number complements, and again subtraction chekuna, what we have done in addition in the same way. So for that, everyone should be perfect how to do binary addition, BCD addition and binary addition. Vachinda andariki, here I got responses, how many? Not more than 10. Mana dantlo 49 unnaru. At least oka 30 responses raval kadamma chat lo result. Now, Any one student tell me what is ones complement, ma'am? Now how to calculate 1011? Ones complement ela cheyali this for this binary number? Anyone?
0100.
Tell me how to do, how you are getting 0100.
Converting ones to zeros and zeros to ones.
Okay, converting ones to zeros and zeros to ones. Good. Other than that, for this number, if you do, if you use one number, you will get this result. What is that number? Final ga formula substitute chesinappudu you have to use if you are having 4 digits you have to subtract with 4 digits, if you are having 5 digits you have to subtract with 5 digits and oka number cheppan kada ma using a formula what number you will get all ones. The main intention is 4 ones minus 1010, finally you will get as 10100. Okay, so if you are doing subtraction for ones complement, what you are doing, you are subtracting with all ones. Okay, so similarly we are in a decimal, so we are in a decimal, try to concentrate, I will end within 2 minutes. We are in a decimal, so decimal base everyone knows it is 10. So what we are doing, we are doing BCD subtraction using, we are doing BCD subtraction using 9s and 10s complement, using 9s and 10s complement. For this, using 9s and 10s complement, first of all, you must know how to do 9s complement. Can anyone here given a number 1, 2, 3 in a decimal, in order to do 9s complement, which number you have to subtract? Ma? 3 ones to subtract, jayala?
Triple nine.
Yes, good. So 999. Okay, na? That is based on the radix. So here previously we have discussed about binary. The radix of that is 2 minus 1. So we have used ones. So R minus 1. This is R's complement. 9's complement means it is R minus 1. This is R. So here you will get 9. So because of that, you are subtracting with 999 minus the given number. Means in the question, it will be asked as find out 9's complement for a number 1, 2, 3. And again, you have to subtract with 9. Now, what is the result? 999 minus 128. What will be the result? Aim was 999 minus 123. Huh?
876.
Okay. Now, for doing 10's complement, what we have to do first? 9's complement ela cheyalo telusindi. 10's complement ela cheyali? Consider the same concept what we used in 1's and 2's. 2's complement cheyalante manam em chesamo?
+1.
For getting 10's. One's complement plus 1. Good. 1's complement plus 1. If you do, we are getting 2's complement. Now I want to calculate not 1's or 2's. I want to calculate 10's complement. For that, what I have to do? 9's complement plus 1. So tell me what will be the result. I want to calculate 10's complement for 1, 2, 3. First, I have to do 9's complement. Already, I have done 9's complement. 999 minus 1, 2, 3. We got the result as 876. 876 plus 1. We have to perform 10's complement. So, you will get finally as 877. Admainda, how to do 9's and 10's complement, everyone? See here. BCD subtraction using 9's and 10's complement. The 9's complement of a BCD number can be obtained by subtracting each digit of BCD from 9. So, I could aim on the question, I'll find out the 9's complement of 168. So, for that, you are subtracting with 999 minus 168 so that you got 831. So, similarly, you need to find out 10's complement. So, 10's complement of a number, this is your 10's complement. The 10's complement of BCD number can be obtained by adding 1 to 9's complement. So, this is your number, 168. So, 999 minus 168, you will get 831. And you need to add 1 so that you will get 832. So, I am ending my. So, here, let me today we have discussed about BCD addition, and we have not started BCD subtraction, but we have started with how to calculate 9's and 10's complement. Okay, so can leave, ma'am.
Ma'am, can you share this PPT in the classroom?
Yes, sure, ma'am. I will share.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.